I'm looking at data from the Rajya Sabha Unstarred Question 1650 December 21, where the government was asked, Gaurav, how many vacancies are there in the armed forces? 97,000 vacancies for JCOs and soldiers in the army, 4,850 in the air force, 11,166 in the navy, 7,000 officer vacancies in the army, 621 air force vacancies, 1,265 officer vacancies in the navy. So the charge against the government is that you haven't been recruiting and you're under pressure. You've seen protests on the issue of no recruitments into the armed forces in states like Haryana, and therefore this is like a employment generation scheme. And the argument being made is, don't think of the armed forces as an employment generation scheme. You need people who are passionate to a point where they are willing to sacrifice their life for the sake of the armed forces, and somebody who served for just 4 years may not have that passion. Gaurav Bhatia.
So Rahul, I heard all the panelists, and with the utmost respect, let me respond one by one. I hope I'll not be interrupted. First of all, this feeble argument that has been given, that you know, only 4 years of service and the person will be very young, why recruit that person? Let me just give you an example of second lieutenant Arun Khetrapal. He was 21 year old, recipient of Paramveer Chakra. He served the country well. He laid down his life. And that is why this tenure argument that is being given, I don't buy that, neither would the citizens of the country.
No, but can I just pause you for a second? Just one second. Hold that thought. Gaurav, hold that thought for a second. Let me ask you a counter to this. Imagine as a young jawan, I'm posted in Bareilly because that's where my 3-year tenure is. Suddenly China or Pakistan decide to launch a war. This gentleman is now moved to the line of actual control or to the line of control. And now you're in high altitude. You've been trained for 6 months and you're out, say, in Bareilly. You have to fight in Tiger Hill or Thululing. That could be a big challenge. I think that's the question that Wing Commander Acharya was asking, that you're posted in one position. Suddenly, in the case of a real combat, you will then be deployed in a different kind of terrain. Gaurav Bhatia.
Rahul, thank you for that question. Let me respond. First of all, are we assuming that our brave and the strongest army in the world of a million plus soldiers will not be there? Why do you assume that the integration would not happen, Rahul? And let me tell you, a study has been undertaken and I'll give you an example. Similarly, these young people are recruited in USA where the training is 8 to 10 weeks market, in France 12 weeks. In UK 14 weeks, we are giving them a training of 6 months and they have the commitment to serve the country well. So let's not discard the new program of the government just because you don't like the government. I think it should be given a chance and it would be very beneficial, not just for the youth,
Rahul,
but also for the country and for our armed forces.
Allow me to speak. Allow me to respond.
Yes, Wing Commander Acharya. Now, once again, let's just do it one by one.
Rahul,
you've made a response. Wing Commander Acharya wants to come in and make a quick counter. I'm going to allow her to do that. This is being done in other armies as well. And if it's working in other armies, why imagine the worst for India, Wing Commander?
See, it is neither a private company nor a corporate. Here we are talking about Indian Armed Forces. And can an officer will take this person on a job? We are creating a class within the men itself. Because one side, people who are going to complete their tenure. Other side, this guy will always be looked down upon. He will always be given sundry jobs like cleaning, maintenance and things like that. Nobody will deploy him. No officer would like to take